going on a Chick-fil-A run. I'm only putting on the filter because I sound better and I think my voice sucks. So it's really nice that we've had it's been raining for the past week and it kind of sucks, but I guess everything looks green. But yeah, going to Chick-fil-A because I'm hungry.
Chicken deluxe meal.
Yeah. And what would you like for your beverage with that?
Sprite.
Yeah. So spicy deluxe meal with a Sprite?
Yeah, can I make the fries large?
Absolutely. Did you want to make the beverage large for
No, thank you.
Okay. Any sauce?
Ranch.
And how many of them would you like?
Can you say that again?
How many would you like?
Just two.
Okay. Anything else for you?
No, thank you. Thank you. She got my number watching a Trisha Paytas video.
I'm trying to help you guys too.
So I'm gonna do a mukbang and watch that at the same time. And if you're here for it, good. If not, bye.
So okay,
let's get started.
Needs to start spawning off. You know what I mean? Like having people underneath him. I think he did that with Manny. I think that was like, so, I don't know. I went with that aside because I was like, Chris Jeffrey's fine. That's fine. Well, whatever. I still think he's like killing it. Like he's doing it right. Okay, I'm gonna put that aside. Mac was hot, so I'd be doing it too. Like Patrick Starr just being over here with his Mac cosmetic lines every like season. That's everything. Just like keeping out of drama. And I don't even know Patrick Starr. And to be honest, like I've heard mixed things about him. I don't know him. Like I literally don't know him. Like he seems cool. He seems to stay out of drama and stuff like that. But he's doing it right, you know what I mean? He just keeps it moving. He's not like, I'm sure there's shit reviews on his products. I'm sure everyone gets shit reviews. Even if they're not shit products, people get shit reviews and people are haters and all that stuff. But he keeps it moving. These apologies after apology videos, like, or even just like explanation videos, like, one, they're annoying. Like, I hate two things I hate on YouTube. It's like explanation and like apology videos that are not necessary or disingenuous. I think those are just so annoying, and I had another one too, and they're just fucking brain because I'm sick. 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 but like the videos where people are like, hey, haven't made a video in 3 months, but I'm back. What do you want to see? And then 3 months later, it's like, I know you guys have been missing, but like, what do you guys want to see? I'm back and I'm ready to make videos. Like, I hate people who are constantly back and being like, what do you want to see? I get like asking people what they want to see, like if you're making videos every day and you're like, I'm kind of running out of ideas, or you guys aren't liking these, or my views are shit, or my views are British on my vlog channel. So I'm like, what do you guys want to see? I know what you guys want to see. You're like, better audio, bitch. So I mean, like, you know, that's cool. Like, at least it helps me. I love the feedback. Thank you for that. That's why I'm using my phone with this MacBook, because, you know, me, I'm just here. Yeah. But not only are they like annoying, I think these like,
my throat hurts.
These like projects, but they're just like, they also make you look like extremely guilty. Like, right? Like, if you truly believe in your product and you're like, I love my product and I've been working my product forever, or whatever the case may be, like, stand behind it. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it just makes you look guilty, like, trying to explain these things. It also kind of like piss off your viewers. Like I said, I am not a fan, a viewer, a hater, or anything. I'm not even like a drama channel, but I like get into this because I'm bored. Like, today I'm just sitting home and I'm just like, I'm gonna catch up on this. Like, it just makes you look guilty, like, from an outsider perspective, but, like, even as, like, someone's fan, I'd be like, why is putting the blame on me? If I was watching someone I love, and they're like, hey, like, you guys, the purchaser, or the buyer, or the viewer is not giving me feedback, so what am I supposed to do? Like, putting blame on me for something, like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. And look, here's the thing, like, if you're gonna get behind product, right? The other thing is, like, moving around and doing so many different palettes with so many different companies. And I know this happens with a lot of people. And like, full transparency, I just watched the Jacqueline one. But this whole video as entirety is about a ton of other people. Because it's not just her that has done this. And it's like, and again, I think Jacqueline followed me, now she unfollowed me. And she's like invited me. Like, she seems very pleasant. She seems like a nice person. So like, this is like no hate on her. But I know people are like, obviously you're talking about Jacqueline. Well, like, stuff she said in her video, yes. But also, like, a lot of people, they bounce around just so many palettes. And, like, I think a lot of this could be avoided. Because I'm not going to lie, like, true, okay, full transparency again. Like, I'm not going to lie, like, I kind of feel bad in a sense because it's, like, either they don't know, right? Either people are not, like, aware, they're really just trying to hustle, or I kind of get it, too. Like, I'm in a different field where, like, I feel like I want to, like, I remember back in the day when I used to do reality television, I would take every reality show that offered it to me, right? But then you get in trouble, like I did recently with like a live show scheduling thing, not my own live show. Well, kind of. I took on a live show I was gonna do in Vegas, and it conflicted with another one, and I'm signing all these contracts to do all these live shows, not realizing they conflict with one another, right? So the point of that is, you know, stick to one. You know, I have Adam and Eve as my sex toy company. You know how many sex toy companies and even big ones will reach out to me, like mainstream sex toy companies will, but it gets messy, like, and also, like, why wouldn't you want to dedicate, you know, I'm going to just, again, reference Jacqueline's video, because she said, well, this one palette was going to be 9 shadows and more money as opposed to the one, okay, so why even, do you see what I'm saying, like, why even, like, put yourself in that position to have that competition, you know, even her highlighters versus shadows, it's like, I would stick, she's like the Morphe cream, right, like, everyone's saying, like, I don't buy from Morphe, although I did buy those diamond brushes, but I don't really buy from them. I don't know, for some reason they always reminded me of, like, do you guys remember those BH Cosmetics? I don't know, they could be totally different, because I'm so out of this makeup game, I don't want to make up with them, I mean, I can't brush my hair, I love a mess. But, so I never got on that bandwagon, but she's obviously, like, it's like a joke at this point, which is fine. Everyone's like, oh my gosh, like, I'm in live show, people are like, Adam and Eve, do a sex therapy, like, it's a joke at some point, where you're just like, okay, you're, which is a good thing, too, like, if you believe in Morphe, like, I believe in Adam and Eve, like, I kind of like being the joker, like, yeah, that's what I do, I do Adam and Eve sex toys, like, you know, I love it, I promote them, I stand by them, Adam and Eve, by the way, shout out, not sponsoring this video, but they're just, like, their products are the shit, anyways, is that if you stand by a company, and you're, like, proud to be that annoying face of them, we'll stand by it, but I think at that point, like, to jump ship, not even jump ship, but to, like, spread yourself out, that'd be, like, me, I'll just put this out there, like, I love Hustler too, but like I'm not gonna start tipping out Hustler because I'm very dedicated and loyal to Adam Neve. Do you know what I mean? I don't ever even purchase anything anymore from Hustler. I used to kind of go there and look, but I truly do love the lingerie and all the toys I can get at Adam Neve. And I've talked to them too about like trying to get like, clothing in there and stuff like that from these different companies because Adam Neve, this sounds like an Adam Neve sponsorship, but long story short, it is kind of like a hub for all these different brands. You know what I mean? And so they take all these sexy brands and put it on their store site, which is really cool. And that's what I love. And they're in America and they're on time and they're reliable. They have, you know, big budget dollars behind them and they're wonderful. So they're great. Anyways. So you can see that it's coming from a person who, like, well, in business too. The other thing that bothers me, and Jacqueline mentioned this in a video, but again, it's not an attack on Jacqueline. Like, it really isn't. Oh my god, this is gonna sound like I'm attacking Jacqueline Hill, and like, I swear it's not. Like, it kind of triggered this, but it was just like this slew of beauty apology and explanation videos, and I'll say my own advice, like, you know, people are gonna come back to me and be like, girl, if you're annoyed by it, why are you watching it? And I totally agree. Like, I had to stop watching these videos, and it's not just, like, Jacqueline, it's, you know, and I wish I couldn't mention other names, because my other pet peeve is when people talk about people, and then you don't know, and you have to go watch these shitty drama channels to figure out who they're talking about, and you have to go give them views, because, like, one thing I do agree with Jacqueline is I'm not a fan of drama channels, here I am a drama channel right now, I'm not a fan of drama channels being, like, catty, or bringing up personal information, or digging for information, or like being investigators. I don't think that's anyone's duty here on YouTube is to be that investigator for people. I don't know, what comes to light comes to light from these companies or whatever cases, you know, but stick up stuff on people. I don't know, to me it seems just a waste. It seems sad to like dig stuff up on people. So again, I'm just kind of like going based on people's videos.
It took too long to focus up.
You're doing all these hustles, me included, right? Like, I know exactly that I get this much money from this, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, music's my shit money, but, like, I'll get some money from that, you know what I mean? But it's, like, it's the low, it's the bottom feeder, and yes, you may not know the exact dollar amount, but you know, to be like, I don't even know how much money I make. Like, either that, or you're, like, the dumbest person in the world, and you got really lucky, you're, like, the luckiest dumb person, because now you're, like, but that's how people also get robbed, just FYI. That's another advice, and I mean that sincerely. Like, clock that money. Because even if you have a business manager, they're going to steal your shit. Look at Dane Cook. Like, his brother was his, like, or stepbrother, somebody, or his brother-in-law was his
Ranch.
Manager, and his sister got stolen. Like, you might want to start clocking that money. You might want to start tracking it. You know what I mean? Like, that's to me when I hear that. It's like, I don't even know. Like, I've heard that so many times. I've heard that so many times, and I'm like, what? Like, either you're trying to manipulate your audience, you're really stupid, or you're just like insanely rich, which I know no one on YouTube is like billionaire status where they don't need money. It's so bizarre, because like, if you really didn't need money and didn't care about money, you'd be putting your music out for free, you'd be putting your pals out for free. Erica Jane used to do free shows for people, you know? Please. I just like that always is like,
too much lettuce.
The money thing in general, too, is just like, what was the other thing someone said? Oh, I think this was a Jacqueline video one, too. I'm sorry, this sounds like a Jacqueline Hill video. It's not, because I've heard other people talk about this, too. When people talk about, like, I should be making $150,000 for a brand deal, or, like, this is the brand deal I take, or these are the brand deals I don't take, or this is why I'm so much better because I didn't take this brand deal. Like, I don't know, and even people have behind-the-scenes stuff and money stuff, I just, like, it rubs me the wrong way as, like, a YouTube creator, because, like, I watch a lot of these videos, and sometimes I hate watch, I'm not gonna lie, like, I'm sure a lot of people watch me and be like, this girl from Mass, she's fatter every day, she's disgusting, she can't brush her hair, like, I'm sure there's a million things people could talk shit about me in my videos for, I'm sure, and there are a lot of people. The good thing is, I know none of these beauty gurus will, like, they don't really clap back. Like, they can be vicious, right? But they're very, like, subtle with their shade. Me, I'm gonna be like, hey, bitch. Any other thing, like, people can clap back at me. I really, like, don't care, whatever. You know what I mean? Like, whatever. And it does kind of, like, bring it. It's kind of, like, warranted. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, right, I'm talking about these people or whatever like that. But at the end of the day, this is kind of just, like, more of a rant, like, puppy thing. And then I'm gonna get to a rant puppy about from the outside of YouTube. I have no idea what I was talking about. That's how I was like, oh, no, no. thing I was talking about. Oh, the money thing? I guess that was the only other thing I was talking about. It's just like, I don't know, for as like a viewer, like I said, when I watch people and they start talking about it, it like makes me cringe. Like, you don't have to say why you're better than someone who's just like a brand deal. You don't have to say how much people get made as a brand deal. You can say, like, in her video specifically, like, someone got $150,000 for mentioning a lipstick or something. Like, what's the point of that? Do you know what I mean? Like, to make people feel bad. Like, I felt bad as soon as I heard it. I'm just like, ew, like, this sucks. Like, what? Like, you know what I mean? And that's why people are like, oh, you guys don't deserve this money or whatever. And I'm not talking about me. I'm talking about, like, in general, people say that about some, you know, especially the beauty community. And so, like, you don't deserve this. And like, well, people work hard. It's like, when you say someone makes $150,000 for flashing lipstick, like, yeah, it's going to piss people off. Like, why even say that? Like, it just, it's kind of like, and for someone like Jacqueline, I'll just say again, because like, she's someone I am, like, I'm not a fan of. Like, well, not that I'm not a fan of, I just, she just makes up videos. Like, it's okay, I don't watch makeup videos. But I used to follow her on Snapchat, and I was kind of a fan of, like, her quirkiness and that she was kind of goofy and different, but also very beautiful. And, like, I don't know, I was, I guess, a fan of her, even though I was a fan of her videos, if that makes sense. And her hustle's amazing. But I don't know, it's just, like, I felt like someone like her, and I've heard that from other people who'd be like, well, I turned down like $200,000 for you. It just rubs people the wrong way. Even say you turned down $200,000 and you didn't leave or something, it just, like, I think it just, like, rubs people the wrong way. And this is also coming from someone who's just like, my $10,000 shopping spree. Yeah, but you don't know how I made that. Maybe I ended up stripping. You know what I mean? I'm not a stripper, but, like, you know what I mean? I could be hooking on the streets or, you know, someone's, you know, whatever the case may be, you know, however anyone gets their money is how they get their money, but. Or maybe I'm completely broke and I just float on designer bags. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm not saying, like,
well, there was that. I ate all my food. And if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like down below. If you want to see more videos like this,
I'm like hustling all over. It's not YouTube. You know what I mean?
Comment below.
Yeah. Anyways, okay.
This is my first, mukbang that but I didn't really speak much in it because I was too focused on Trisha.
I'm trying to think. I know the channel name. I'm not trying to get that. I'm trying to think of the part that I really, really like. Oh, I love it.